Hi everybody, John here from All Miniatures Great and Small, and today we're going to continue our build-up of the UCM Battleship. So I have assembled the battleship, and you saw that in the previous video, or at least hopefully you did. I'll have a link down below if you haven't seen that. Again, we assembled this as the Beijing slash Tokyo class. So what we're going to do is go ahead and go through our painting tutorial today. So first thing we did was we base coated our miniature. We always base coat our miniature so that the paint has a better surface to adhere to. I used, let me zoom out here, Tamiya fine surface primer, a light gray, just because it's what I had handy. I know, I think Hawk War Games recommends this type of primer. I like it for a lot of things unless I just need to prime something black or white for miniatures, but it works great, especially since this ship is going to end up gray. So what are we going for here? We just went outside and primed it with the spray, and then we're going to take you through the steps of painting it. Ultimately, we want to end up with this color scheme. This is what we're going for. This is a Seattle class carrier, and that's the end result we're aiming for. Next, we're going to talk about what paints we need. So these are the primary paints we're going to use to paint our spaceship. We're going to start with the grays, and basically we just need a palette of grays. I'm using GW grays for the most part. I have Dawnstone, which is going to serve as our base, and then some lighter grays as well for the highlighting. We have Gloss Agrax Earthshade and Gloss Null and Oil. That's to the Gloss Null and Oil is black shade, which will shade the grays, and the Null and Oil will be shading our bronze that we use for the engines. So we're going to be painting our engines bronze. Then we have some Vallejo Game Color Ghost Gray. It's just a very light blue gray, which is great for picking out highlights, escape pods, guns, things like that. We might be using that. And then we have these three colors for the yellow highlights, like a base coat, the main yellow, and then a highlight of yellow. And that is about it. Oh, sorry. And of course, we're going to be using Lead Belcher, which is metallic, and that will be for gun barrels and various detail parts as well. So there you go. Those are the colors we are going to be using for today. All right, first up, we're going to give this a base coat of Dawnstone. I like this Dawnstone Air. This is the Air version. Even though I'm not using my airbrush today, it's a little bit thinner than the regular Dawnstone, and it'll go on a little bit easier. Even though it's thinner, I am going to thin it down even more with a little bit of Lamy and Medium, just so we get a nice even coat, and that's what we're going to base everything off. So we're just going to start with basically just one brush of Lamy and Medium, and we'll go with two, and a couple of brushfuls of the Dawnstone, and always give them a good shake. And that should be enough for us to get started. And mix up our paints a little bit. And basically all we're going to do is get this on everything we can. You can see this Dawnstone is a lot darker than the Tamiya primer that I used. You could always use a darker primer as well and probably save yourself a couple of coats. So we're going to go ahead and base coat this. Again, it's probably going to take a couple of passes, and then we'll be back with the next step. So we have applied our layer of Dawnstone to the battleship. Our next step is going to be painting the engines, and we're going to be using Vallejo Game Color Brassy Brass. We're going to break that down with a little Lamian Medium. I didn't want to go with traditional lead belcher steel looking engines. I wanted to give the model some kind of contrast. So we went with the brass for the engines this time. So let's get it in focus. And so what we'll do is we'll pick out all the engines in this brass color. Then we will be right back. All right, so the brass is now down on the engines. We also picked out some of the anti-gravity coils or spars or whatever they are. We're going to be picking these out all in different colors to just give it some variety on the bottom. So the next step is going to be wash. We're going to use two washes. We're going to use gloss Nuln oil for the gray. We're going to cover the whole thing in that. Except for the engines are going to get a coat of gloss Agrax Earthshade. So I like these over the standard shades. The gloss one's better, especially for something like this where it's not going to darken the gray too much, but it'll still get in all the recesses, and it'll do keep things like the engines still shiny, but give them more definition. So it's pretty straightforward. All we're going to do is we'll start with the Agrax Earthshade on these engines. Is cover them up straight out of the pot, not diluted or anything like that. And we'll do that. So we're going to go ahead and wash the model, and we'll be back. Okay, the Agrax Earthshade is down on the engines. And I'm going to go ahead and do the Nuln oil now on the rest of the ship. I'm going to use a bigger brush just because there's a lot of battleship to cover with this. And basically we're just going to slap it on, making sure we push it around before it dries and gets in all the recesses. And then we'll be back. Okay, we have the base coat of Nuln oil down on the ship, and it's going to dry. This takes a little bit longer than normal paints and washes to dry, so we're going to go ahead and let it sit, and then we'll be back to start highlighting it up. Just to note, one thing I forgot that I could have done before applying the washes was the lead belcher for things like the gun barrels and antennas and little AA guns on the side. But we can do that as its own step, paint those up and wash them and highlight them separately. So not a big deal if you forget it at this step. It doesn't really impact what we're doing. I might end up throwing up another coat of wash on these engines, but we'll see once it dries what the final effect looks like. So there you go, and we'll be back once it's dry. Okay, the Nuln oil wash has dried, and we'll see that it's still nice and glossy. There's some splotches there. So the next step is tidying this up. So we're going to go back with our Dawnstone, and we're going to cover up. The important thing is primarily the top of the ship. We want to lighten up the top of the ship. We'll go back with the brush over all of it, but we're primarily going to concentrate our layers on the top and make that the brightest. So we're going to use our Dawnstone Air. And this air is actually thin enough, and I've worked on this with the other example, that I can paint this out of the pot. And basically, this is probably the most tedious part of the model, is going over it with this paint. So we're going to go ahead and do that, and we'll be back.
Okay, so now we have the base coat of Dawnstone applied to the majority of the ship, basically going back over those panels and starting to build up the brightness and the color. So I'm leaving a couple of the spots open. That's eventually where we're going to paint some lead belcher to give the top of the ship some contrast. But the next step is going to be to highlight up the armor. So we're going to use our Dawnstone, which is our base coat, with some administrative gray. So we're going to mix those two up together to get kind of a half and half mix. And we're going to highlight all of the panels. Again, concentrating on the topmost so that they will be the brightest. So now that I've got my color mixed, we're just going to go ahead and start adding that to the ship. And again, highlighting these panels is probably one of the most tedious things. The ship really doesn't start to come together and start looking awesome until you feel like you're almost done with the project. You feel like you have a mess on your hands, and then it all of a sudden snaps into shape, and it's like, wow, this looks cool. So we're going to go ahead and highlight up the ship, and then be right back.
Okay, so the highlight layer is complete on the battleship. So you can see on the top, it's a lot lighter than the sides. Our next step is we're going to go back now and pick out all the gun turrets, barrels, all these little doodads and detail bits on the side of the ship in lead belcher. And then we're going to put a wash over it. Okay, we've got our lead belcher here, thinned down with some Lamian medium, and basically we're going to hit everything that we want to be metallic gunmetal. So for example, the barrels on these turrets. Are going to be. And we'll go around, we'll pick out any interesting bits, like there's some tubes and conduits in these gaps. These anti-grav coils, we're going to paint a bunch of those with lead belcher as well. And a couple of these panels on the back of the ship, we're going to pick out in lead belcher, as well as all these little self-defense guns. So we're going to go ahead and do that, and we'll be back. We are back after the application of lead belcher. So here you can see the metallic sections along the back. We also picked out the guns. We did some of the sections and anti-grav coils on the bottom. So, and we did the gun barrels for all the mass driver turrets. So now we're going to use a regular Nuln oil, not the gloss, to go into these recesses here and darken up the guns. So we're going to go ahead and do that, and we will be back. And we're just going to use Nuln oil out of the pot. And we want to go in to these crevice areas here and darken that up. We might end up using more than one coat in here just to make this area nice and dark. Anyway, we're going to go ahead and apply the Nuln oil over all of the lead belcher that we've applied, and then we'll come back. Okay, we've put the Nuln oil onto the metallics, onto that lead belcher, and we are ready to move on to the yellow. So we're going to be adding the yellow highlights so that it will match the rest of the fleet. We're going to use as a base for the yellow, we're going to put down some Vallejo Desert Yellow, just because it's more opaque than the final yellows we're going to be using, and it'll lay down a good base coat for us to put. So we're going to go ahead and use that with some Lamian medium. We get a little bit of that. And some Lamian medium. 6. And then, oh, sorry, it's a tripod. We start, I like having the bow of the ship in yellow. So we're going to start here. Basically, it'll take a couple of coats to get the brown the way we want. Then we'll be back and apply the next. What we're going to do is we get the front of the ship. We're also going to highlight the turrets and just some areas in the back. All right, so we have the desert yellow down on the model and all the spots that we want. Now we're going to go back and cover that with our Citadel Uriel yellow. All right, we've got our yellow thinned down with some Lamian medium here. We're going to go ahead and basically go over everything that we've done with that brown. And we'll go ahead and get this covered, and we'll be right back. All right, the yellow is down. Now the next step is highlighting. So we're going to go through with very light gray and highlight these panels, and also highlight the yellow a little bit. And we're getting close to being done. So our edge highlighting is going to be done with Ghost Gray. This is Vallejo game color with some Lamian Median. We want this to be pretty thin because we're going to be making very, very thin lines. We also want to make sure we have a brush that has the point we need. So I will be using this is probably the finest brush I have. It's a Winsor Newton 222, and it's got a nice long point to it, which will be good for coming in and laying down these lines. Okay, we've gone in and done all the panel highlighting. With that same color, we also picked out some of the details on the side of the hull. Those escape pods or whatever they are, we painted those white. We didn't get every edge just because probably be a little bit too busy for the model, but we did get the important ones. So there you go, there's the head edge highlighting. We're gonna go ahead and tidy this up and we'll be right back. All right, so there you go. We are finished with the last steps and our spaceship is pretty much in a state where we can start playing with it. Now, like pretty much any miniature, you're never really done with this. This ship could be highlighted even further. You could add more contrasting colors to it. You could add decals or numbers. But as a good basic paint job, this will definitely work and it will fit in my fleet. The mighty Beijing has joined the Dropfleet. So there you go, folks. I hope you enjoyed this simple painting guide. If you did, go ahead and give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, leave your thoughts down below in the comments. Thanks again, and keep on wargaming.